Good afternoon, everybody.
Krista Freeland emerged from 5 hours of high-level meetings empty-handed, but not disappointed.
We have entered, over the past couple of weeks, very much including today, a new, more intensive phase of engagement.
The re-energized discussions will be handed over to the chief negotiators, who will keep talking over the next few days. CBC News has learned NAFTA partners are close to an agreement in principle that would focus heavily on the auto sector. A source with direct knowledge of the talks says the details could be worked out in a matter of weeks, or it could even be completed before the heads of all three countries meet late next week at the Summit of the Americas.
Well, we're all working very hard to try and get to make as much progress as we can in as short a period of time.
Looming elections in Mexico this summer and the U.S. this fall are partly behind the recent drive to work faster. And there are clear signs the political will to get to a deal is there. Delegations from all three countries met last night for a friendly dinner to set the mood for today's discussions. Even with the smiles and hugs, there is much work ahead. But for Canada's Foreign Affairs Minister, who has spent months trying to keep this deal alive, these developments are positive.
I think she really is reassured that the U.S. isn't going to pull the plug on this deal, that we probably can come to a successful negotiation eventually.
Canada is desperate for that kind of reassurance. The longer there is uncertainty around NAFTA, the more likely it is that investors will choose to put their money in the U.S. rather than Canada. Katie Simpson, CBC News, Washington.